Welcome to the Swan Show, your weekly update on all things Swansea City. Coming up this week,
we sit down with Andy King ahead of Saturday's big game at Huddersfield Town.
But first, we're hitting the road with Swansea City's finest, Alan Curtis.
One of the Swans' greatest ever players, he has excelled both on and off the pitch during a lifetime of service to the club. Now Kurt tells the Swan Show about his latest role.
Al, just over a year now, you've been the Swans' first lone player manager. You're used to this, aren't you? Life on the road, heading around the country and further afield sometimes to see the Swans players who are out on loan.
Yeah, not quite this luxury, mind, Guy, you know, sat at the back. Lakey, to be fair, Hulick does come with me a lot, but sometimes obviously you've got to drive by yourself. But yeah, it's been great. I mean, it's been... I think it was certainly the transition, you know, from coaching the players and then to actually becoming the loan manager. It was a little bit difficult because you actually missed the day-to-day involvement. Obviously, you've got your reports to do and you go to watch games. But a lot of the time, you know, it's a sort of, you're almost killing time a little bit. So that was a little bit strange. But, you know, well over a year into it now. And, you know, it's really enjoyable when somebody says that, you know, you just wanted to go and watch football matches. And especially, you know, when you go to watch our players in a different environment, play for different clubs, then it's really good. You know, I'm sort of really starting now to really enjoy it.
Are you missing, you mentioned it there, are you missing... That you've been for so long, you've been on the training pitch every day, haven't you? Do you miss that now?
Yeah, I think you do, Gab. You don't think you'll ever really get used to that. But you've become accustomed to it now. The fact that you're not out there. Certainly, you know, with the beast from the east last week, then I was quite happy sort of watching the boys, training while I was in the warm. But it's a little bit strange, but no, it's something that, you know, that I've gone, you know, got used to now, and just readily accept it. It's as I say, it really is an important job, you know. Sort of slight jokes aside, the fact that the players go out, it's important that they get in game time, and. As I say, my job, not only just to monitor the players to play it, but you know, certainly for the younger players to make sure that they stay in the right accommodation, they're eating properly. But it's really important that they're happy in the environment that they're in. And if they're happy, then they hopefully will produce their best football. We keep in touch. I mean, I keep in touch with all the players. It's either phone calls or text messages anyway. We obviously text them before the game to wish them all the best, how are things, try and find out if they're playing. And then obviously afterwards, then on the Sunday usually, get back in touch with them to find out how the game went. You do your reports, and obviously, you know, like tonight, we know we're going to watch Swansea playing at Cardiff. See Oli. You try and get first-hand experience of watching them play as well.
So you try, as you say, one big thing is trying to watch the lads going in.
Yeah.
And I guess it's nice for them to know that there's someone from Swansea City, but yourself.
I think it's really important.
Checking on what they're doing.
Absolutely, I think it's really important. You know, and I keep in touch not only with the players, you keep in touch with the coaches, the managers of the respective clubs, just really to sort of, you know, to get some feedback from them, you know, how they're doing, not only in games, but how they're doing in training, have they settled down, you can find a little bit more about their character as well. You know, sometimes quite interesting to see what other people have, their perspective of our players. But, the whole thing of obviously all the players going out on loan, so they get game time. Younger players, that they where they come back, they're a little bit more experienced. Mm. And obviously some of the senior players, it gives them valuable game time if they're not getting it at their home club.
Tell us a bit about what it entails. In terms of match days, you mentioned Hugh Lake, another former Swan, driving the van kindly in the front.
We don't always do this luxury.
You've been all over the country, haven't you?
Yeah, we have. Obviously, we know we've been to Mansfield. I mean, aside from the football, you know, you get to taste the cuisine, so to speak. I mean, we've got the best pies, definitely. You know, we both agreed to that.
You have a pie on every trip, do you?
Well, we've got to, I think it's very important that we sort of sample the atmosphere and the catering facilities.
Does that
as
feature
well
in your report as well?
Well, I think, you know, that's probably one of the reasons why I do take Lakey, is that he's quite an expert on culinary matters. As I say, you know, you go and it's well, you keep in touch with all the players. It's vital as well that you actually go to see them play,
yeah,
and make them aware of that you're going to play, so that they're not out on loan or they're just forgotten about. You know, there is somebody looking after them. And as I say, a report back then, you know, the reports go to the chairman, they go to the manager, they go to Nigel Rees at the academy. So it's important that they keep in touch with them anyway, but, you know, mine is a sort of almost like a first-hand knowledge.
And what about Carlos Carvajal? Do you speak to him?
Yeah, speak
regularly,
to Carlos.
I think.
Yeah, you speak to Carlos. He gets the same reports as well. But occasionally, you know, we like obviously, you know, with Oli, because Oli has played a little bit of first-team football and has been around the squad and trained the squad probably more than most. Then, you know, I'll make it a point to go and see Carlos this week and, you know, tell him firsthand, you know, how I thought that Oli has played, a little bit of feedback, you know, from Oli himself, how he's enjoying it. And so, you know, it's quite a good, probably a good service, I would have thought, you know, that the manager, you know, he's obviously got to be able to trust my judgment, you know. And I mean, it was used a little bit with Connor Roberts.
Yeah, he mentioned it, I was going to say, mentioned it when... Yeah. He'd only been at the club a week or so, hadn't he? He needed a right back.
He needed a right back, you know. And you know, what do I think? You know, with Connor, I think everybody has seen that Connor. You know, I'd seen Connor play it quite a few times, playing for Middlesbrough, mainly cup games, a little bit like he is with us at the moment.
Yeah.
And you go and see Connor play, and then yeah, I mean, he's got the athleticism for one that you know, he could easily play in the Premier League. Obviously, the experience will come through playing games, but. You know, and I think that he showed that in the games that he's played so far.
And tonight, you mentioned, we're going to see Oli McBurnie.
Oli, yeah.
Not been at Barnsley long, but he certainly seems to have made an impact.
Yeah, I did go to see him. I went to see him about a fortnight ago against Birmingham. And to be fair, he was terrific. You know.
Do you think he's one with the raw materials to make it in the Premier League?
He's a goal scorer. And I think that, you know, people always need goal scorers. I mean, his value certainly at the moment, you know, is probably gone up. It's going through the roof at the moment because he's a young goal scorer, and everybody's looking for goal scorers. I mean, he's somebody that hopefully will come back definitely better for the experience and come back and really push for a first team place.
He's playing. We're on the M4, on our way to
our friends up the road.
Yeah, to the Cardiff City Stadium. I think you've spoken to Oli, or did you say you texted him to...
Yeah, I spoke to him, I texted him, yeah, obviously to wish him all the best.
And warn him.
I've told him that he might well get, you know, a bit of a frosty reception.
Yeah.
I mean, he's coming, you know, he's the type of character, I think that he's really looking forward to it, he said. And I think he'd be a little bit disappointed, you know, if they didn't go. No, he's got four goals now in four or five games.
Uh-huh.
I'd love him to get a goal tonight, and I hope he doesn't celebrate... too vigorously or with...
If he does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
May be a Jack, but Kurt was given a warm welcome at Cardiff. He watched on as the home side took 3 points despite a second half goal from McBurnie. Kurt wasn't the only Jack at the Cardiff City Stadium in midweek. Midfielder Tom Carroll was among a contingent of Swans on the away end to see Oli McBurnie in action. Personal note, is that 5 in 5 starts? I think you've got to be pleased with that.
Yeah, like I said, the reason for me to come out on loan is to get some goals, get some games, and get a bit of confidence, you know. And like you said, 5 goals in my first 5 starts is good, but bittersweet tonight, obviously, with the result, and it would have been nice to get one over on them as well.
And he got the frosty reception you predicted, you warned him about.
Yeah, he did, and I thought, to be fair, he thrived on it. You know, I mean, I think again, he's quite a strong character anyway. That didn't faze him at all, and I thought he got stronger as the game went on. So, and the more that they, you know, they had a go at him and they booed him, gave him stick, then I thought the better he responded.
All the Barnsley boys have been saying, like, how do they, like, know what you're doing and stuff, do they just keep an eye out? And I think they're a bit surprised when they seen Kirk coming to all the games and stuff, and they really keep a firm interest on, and I know Kirk keeps everyone at Swansea updated and stuff about how I'm getting on and stuff, so it's pleasing for you, because you know that it's always getting back how you're doing, and it means you if you're playing well, it's going back, and if you're not playing so well, Kirk will give you a kick up the backside, like I've had a couple of times off him so far.
Always nice to see a friendly face around here.
Swansea City climbed to a lofty 13th place in the Premier League table after last weekend's rousing 4-1 win over West Ham. Ki Sung Young, Mike van der Horn, Andy King and Jordan Ayew all found the target in the Swans' 7th straight home victory. Now the challenge is to succeed on the road when Carlos Carvajal's side face Huddersfield this weekend. Off the field, the Swans have officially launched their defibrillator programme in memory of local footballer Mitchell Joseph. The club have matched the £10,500 raised by Mitchell's family and friends at the Liverpool home game and are also buying a defibrillator for each goal scored by the Swans between January and the end of the season.
There's certainly a positive come out of this tragedy, you know, and we all know as a family that Mitchell would have wanted this. And I think this has brought the community of Swansea together, and it's just showed that how generous and how supportive the people of Swansea really are. And it's been quite overwhelming really, but absolutely fabulous, fantastic.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying it. Yeah, I knew a couple of the boys before I came, which I think has helped me settle in. But yeah, the lads have been great with me, as have all the staff. And yeah, like I said, I'm really enjoying it. It was obviously a strange, strange thing to happen. It all happened quite quickly and stuff like that. So I think that's maybe made it a little bit easy. You know, I wasn't really expecting it to come, and then it happened. So just had to sort of dive in and embrace it. And that's what I've managed to do. Like I said, I think knowing a couple of the boys before has helped me. And obviously I play with Wales as well. So it's not like I've just played in with one set of lads and stuff like that. You know, in football, people move around every 6 months so often. You sort of have to prove yourself again, you know, when you come to a different team, you know, you've got to sort of try and show people what you can do, try and show you sort of the new teammates what you can do and stuff like that. So yeah, it's maybe like almost like a new lease of life and having to prove yourself, not to yourself or to supporters or anything like that, but also to almost to the change room and to show that you deserve to be there. Yeah, I think so. You know, it's sort of taken a while for me to come. You know, the first week I came here, we were playing Leicester, so I couldn't play. I think we played 3 or 4 cup games, you know, over the weekend as well. So I've sort of been here a month and only really played one game, and I'd only been able to play like 1 or 2 out of about 6 games, I think. So to go out there and to perform the way the team did and for me to get the goal was obviously really pleasing. We know what we need to do. We're 13th at the moment, but we're only ever one result away from going back in the bottom three. I think it's 2 or 3 points outside relegation. So we know that as much as the table looks right at the moment, it's not a case of how many teams are below us, but it's how many points they are behind. And that can all change with one weekend of football. So we need to make sure that we keep it going and we've got a points target which we need to hit. And yeah, we won't be happy till we do that. He's really good, you know, he's a good character. You know, he's lively, which I think is good in a position like Swansea are in. You know, you need someone to come in and speak with the players and who the players can enjoy, you know, having stories with and stuff like that. And he's good fun to be around, but when you go out onto the pitch, you know that you have to work for him and you know he won't accept anything less than 100%. The bigger character managers have always sort of got the better out of me. I seem to respond better to that. So yeah, I'm enjoying working with him a lot at the moment. I think he's definitely got all the characteristics to hopefully keep the team in the league and who knows what will happen after that. Played against Huddersfield earlier in the season, you know, away up there, and they're a really good team. You know, they've got a game plan which they all know and stick to, and they're really good at putting that out on a Saturday. They want to get in your faces, they like to press. We obviously like to press as well, so, you know, I'm sure it'll be sort of pretty end-to-end game. And yeah, with so much on the line as well, I'm sure it'll be pretty competitive. You know, playing football ultimately is a challenge and one which everyone who plays enjoys. So I think it's going to be one of the main things, you know, if you can go out there and sort of not freeze under the pressure and enjoy your football, enjoy being part of the team, then you've got a good chance of doing well, yeah.